Hi, Little Sprouts. I bring you today a non-fiction book called A Day at the Apple Orchard. Now, I can tell that this is a non-fiction book just by looking at the cover before I even open the book. And that's because this has real-life pictures that are included in this book. And if something is able to be in a picture, that means it's a real thing. So these authors, Megan Faulkner and Adam Krawski, are telling us some true information about a day at the apple orchard. It's a sunny day in early fall. Perfect for apple picking. Before we go into the orchard, we learn how apples are grown. Let's stop right there. Do you know what the word orchard means? An orchard is a special farm that grows apples on apple trees. It has taken many months for them to grow and ripen. Just like all living things, apples need the right amount of rain and sun to be healthy. The life of an apple tree begins in the spring. During the winter months, the tree doesn't grow or change. This stage is called dormancy. That just means that the tree is sleeping. Warm weather awakens the tree and it begins a new cycle of growth. So in the spring, you see these teeny tiny little buds. Leaves push out from the tiny buds. So here's what the bud looks like. And eventually a leaf comes out. Five petal blossoms grow in beautiful shades of pink or white. These, believe it or not, look like they're just regular blossomed flowers, but they're not. They're going to grow into something special. Apple farmers set up beehives in the orchard. When a honeybee lands on an apple blossom, it sips the sweet nectar. That's the part inside the flower. Tiny grains of pollen stick to its legs. As the bee flies from flower to flower, the pollen it carries fertilizes the blossoms. This is called pollination. Thank you, bees, for pollinating those flowers. As spring turns into summer, the flower petals fall from the trees. You can see there's petals everywhere. On the branches, ovaries begin to grow, right here. They will become apples. All summer long, the apples get bigger and bigger. Doesn't that look like a delicious apple? As autumn approaches, autumn is another word for the season of fall, the apples start to ripen. Ripen means they're ready to be picked. They turn from green to red. Now some apples stay green, like Granny Smith. They stay green all the time. Others, such as Golden Delicious, turn yellow. By late summer or early fall, the apples are ripened. It's harvest time. Harvest time means time to go pick those apples. We pick up our baskets and get ready for a tractor ride. The tractor takes us into the orchard. We're picking Empire apples today because they are the ripest. Empire apples is just one name for a type of apple. There are so many good types of apples. Before we start, we learn the best way to pick an apple. Instead of pulling it off the tree, we must turn the eye, which is the bottom, right here, to the sky and tug gently. We want to make sure that the bud is not damaged for next year. So by pulling the apple off the tree gently, it means the tree does not get damaged and can grow apples next year. It's time to start picking. Apples bruise easily, so we place them very gently into the basket. I'm sure you've seen a bruise on an apple. That's like when it gets hit and it's brown. That's a bruise on the apple. So they're trying not to get their apples bruised. While we are picking, we see wire guards at the bottom of the trees. We aren't the only ones who like apple trees. Apple farmers must safeguard the trees from hungry creatures such as rabbits, rodents, and insects. What that means is they're keeping their trees safe so the animals can't crawl up there and snatch up those yummy apples. Our baskets are full. It's time to head back to the farm. Now we sample the apples. Crisp and delicious. Next, we see how apple juice and cider are made with an old-fashioned hand press. That's this machine right here. First, the apples are put in the press. Then we turn the crank and cider comes out the bottom. So pretty much this machine squeezes the apples so much that the juice comes out right there. Then we have a taste test. How many of you like apple juice or apple cider? I sure do. It's been so much fun learning about apples. We can't wait to come back next year. That's the end. Let me see what you can remember from our apple book, friends. Okay? I want to see who remembers what the very first thing that pops off the stem is called in the spring. It's a bud. All right, let's see. Who helps pollinate the flowers so that those flowers can become apples? Why, it's the honeybees, of course, and with their pollination, they can also make us honey, so they help us out twice. Let's see here. Oh, yes. I want you to see if you can practice the proper way to pick an apple. So, pretend like you're at an apple farm. Reach out, grab that apple. Remember, you have to pull the bottom up and then gently tug. What were they making right here, friends? They were making apple juice and apple cider. Now that you've read about the apple orchard, I want you to think about different things that we make with apples. Applesauce? Apple pies, apple cookies, there are so many. I want you to talk about with your family, what are the yummiest things that come from apples?